Then there are different kind of project which is going on in the name of e-governance, that is Bhumi projects, they are very popular. Then e-procurement, that's very popular. MCA 21, Gyandut, Lokwani, Friends, Mitra. I mean, these are very e-governance platforms by providing different kind of services to the people or the citizen around it. Now, coming to the legal framework, what is the legal framework under which this e-governance, you know, activities are done? That has to be understood. Now, we already discussed that, see, unlike in US, where the e-governance act is there, India doesn't have any electronic governance. And so, we have only Information Technology Act, which talks about e-commerce, or which talks about cyber crime, but which doesn't talk about e-governance. Now, in that background, there are certain sections which can be used or which can be read in the context of e-governance. Now, there is a concept of intermediary. You can understand the concept of intermediary properly if you refer back to the module of Internet Mediatories Liability. That particular module discusses the different kind of, or the concept of Internet intermediaries and their liabilities. Now, here the government, when they are providing, they are making use of e-governance concept and making use of information technology to provide different kind of services to people, they are actually performing a duty of a intermediary when they are providing the content, when they are developing the content, when they are regulating the content, they are nothing but the intermediary. So, Section 79 of the IT Act will regulate their behavior or their role with regard to the liability, if any. So, the government is supposed to provide the e-governance or create the contents under the parameter of Section 79 of the Act. For further discussion, you can refer back to the module of Internet Mediatories. Then the other act is there, which is recently enacted in 2016 itself, that is Aadhaar Targeted Delivery of Financial and Other Subsidies Benefit of Services Act 2016. Now, this is one act which to a great extent is created to incorporate or to facilitate the e-governance as such. So, the act defined the biometric information, it defined the demographic information, it defined the identity information, which are important, which is collected by the government for the purpose of providing different kind of schemes or for providing or regulating the people who are using or the people who are benefiting, benefited by the different kind of state sponsored welfare activities and so on. Then the next government initiative with regard to e-governance was in the form of a framework for citizens' engagement in e-governance. Because at the end of the day, this whole e-governance has been created for the welfare purposes of its citizens. So, somehow the citizen has to be engaged in the overall concept of e-governance to make it more effective. So, government has created a framework as to how to involve them in the important decision making of e-governance. And this particular chart shows step by step how the governance, what kind of framework is required to engage the citizen in the overall governance. It has been properly elaborated in the module, in the written module. Then another framework was created, that was framework and guidelines for the use of social media for government organization. Now, in the process of providing a government e-governance by government institution, somehow they are involved in social media or different kind of social media. While they are somehow engaged in social media in doing governance or e-governance, they have to respond or they have to behave in a certain manner. Now, this framework is creating some kind of guidelines with regard to it. Like it says, always identify yourself, your role in the department. Second, do not comment or respond unless authorized in case of matters sub judice, draft legislation and relating to individuals. Then don't make irrelevant statements. Conversation has to be productive and of logical conclusion. Then maintain professionalism in attitude, be polite, discreet and respectful, no personal comment. Open to positive or negative comments, though not necessary to respond to each query. Then compliance to relevant laws and regulation. Then maintain the privacy of other individual as well as own private and personal information. So, this is what a kind of guidelines which has been issued. Then before entering into social media and while in e-governance, whether which platform of social media has to be selected, all this has been given under the guidelines. Now, there are e-governance while is very beneficial, no doubt about it, as we have already discussed, and the different kind of legal framework which has been created by the government to make it possible, that is fine. By the same time, e-governance also creates some kind of challenges which is still there before the government, and it has to be seen that how they address it. Like the first one is privacy and data protection. Now, government in the form of providing e-governance is collecting lot of privacy and data protection, data related issues with regard to individual. Now, those data may be very confidential in nature, those data may be containing various religious information, caste information, about age information, medical health information and so many. And now, these informations are important and they also falls in the category of sensitive information if you see from the IT Act perspective. And they are also in the nature of privacy. Now, government has to maintain the privacy of it. How far the government can maintain it, that is an important issue. Now, we do not have a specific legislation with regard to privacy protection. We are still debating it, whether privacy is a fundamental right or not. In this background, we do not have any legislation, though IT Act to some extent talks about it. In that background, the apprehension is that if the information reaches to a wrong hands or to a wrong person, then there are chances that it will be misused. There are plenty of examples of this nature where privacy and data protection is a major issue and it has been breached. There are reports of breach and its misuse, and if it is misused, then there will be huge loss. And loss in terms of not economic, but about confidence, trust and many other things. So, how to protect and to develop a proper system of protection of privacy is an important issue. It has to be seen how government respond to it, how authentically and how serious they are all about it. But yes, at this point of time, we can say we do not have any specific legislation, and we are and the legislature are still debating on the issue and trying to come out with some kind of development on this regard. Then security, the information has to be secure. There are hackers, there are crackers. Now, hackers are looking for the opportunity to crack the information, to hack the information. And there are instances, recently the news of banks data being leaked and hacked is an important issue. So, it's very wrong. So, how far the security can be maintained, that is important. Then illiteracy, major portion of the population is illiterate, and how they can access the e-governance, that is an important things to understand. And then the issue of infrastructure, we are only 17% of the population are using internet, and to the remote area there is no internet connectivity and it is not proper. So, till the time it doesn't reach to each and every area, it will not be a futile exercise, it will not be a very useful exercise. So, therefore, infrastructure is also an important challenge for the government. So, these are the some of the main important challenge. In all e-governance concept, all these discussions were done as per the objective set in the beginning of the lecture. I hope that you must be going through the modules, different modules, in fact this modules also, and I wish you best of luck for your exams. And in case of any kind of doubts, any kind of confusion, you can always refer back to us for further discussion. Thank you.